Hi, I'm Judy. I'm a Virginia Master Naturalist at Claytor Lake State Park. And one of the things that I do volunteering out here is monitor our vernal pools. Claytor Lake Park has 3 vernal pools. This is the largest one. We call this one the entrance pool. A vernal pool is a body of water that is not connected to any other body of water. Some of them can be in stream beds where the streams dry up. Some of them are just a body of water of just like road. It could be road runoff. It could be a rut, a tire rut with water in it. But they're not connected to any other body of water. Vernal means spring. So they are formed of snowmelt and rain in the winter and the fall. And then in the spring, there's a whole lot of water in them. The reason it's important that they're not connected to other bodies of water is because there are no fish in a vernal pool. So there's a lot less predation on the young. The animals that live in the vernal pools have to grow up really fast. A vernal pool is important in the habitat. There are animals that live in vernal pools that breed only in vernal pools. They're called vernal pool obligates. There are also a number of species of salamanders and one species of frog, the wood frog, which we do have in this pool, that live in these pools. They are all amphibians, and they lay their eggs in the water. The young hatch, and they've got maybe 2 to 3 months before they metamorphose into adults. So we're going to monitor this vernal pool today, go around and look and see what we can find in it. Not all the animals in the vernal pool are obligates. This is a leech. This is the first thing that I caught when I took my net into the vernal pool. We also today have seen wood ducks and mallards. We have painted turtles in this pool, a number of different frogs, species of frogs, bullfrogs, spring peepers. Wood frogs are obligates. And we're hearing tree frogs as well today. We're going to put this guy back in the water. Frog tadpoles are characterized by the golden flecks on them. This is the pretty one. This is a caddis fly. I don't know if he'll come out or not when he's not in the water. I'm going to drop him down in there. Caddis fly is an insect that the larvae grow up in the water and they gather stuff. I think it just pinched the newt. They gather various bits of sticks and branches and such and build a little home around them. So the insect is what you see kind of trying to get poked out here. But the rest of it is what he built. This is an eastern red-spotted newt. This is probably one of the major predators in our vernal pool. We also do have bullfrogs and turtles that eat all these things. There's a green heron that hangs out here sometimes. This particular newt is a male. You can see the glands at the base of the tail there. I don't know if you can. And we have a female as well. She's really fat, probably getting ready to lay eggs. Newts lay their eggs in water, and they spend a very short period of time in the water as a gilled larva, and then they climb out on land and they turn bright red, kind of orange red. They're called a red F, and they can live up to 7 years on land before they go back in the water and become adults, and they stay in the water as adults. They kind of do everything backwards from all the other salamanders. This guy here, is a bullfrog tadpole. Bullfrogs are, they spend 2 years in the water as babies. So this baby was hatched last year, and at the end of this year, if he's lucky, if he's fast enough, he'll be able to turn into an adult, metamorphose into an adult, and live on land like the bullfrog that we had out there. We have a water boatman swimming around. I don't think I can catch it. This is a water boatman. I've got another larval salamander, probably a Jefferson's, but not for sure. Oh, there it is. And this is a juvenile dragonfly, also live in water. They are voracious predators, and they get a lot bigger than this, both as adults and as juveniles. So this is another one that's eating our vernal pool obligates. I think that's all I got in there.